This podcast is brought to you by the Washington State Department of Health. As we continue to listen, learn, and grow, we are amplifying Black voices and perspectives in an effort to start a new COVID-19 vaccine conversation. We're sharing stories intended to help us navigate this unprecedented time together and to co-create solutions in support of the Black community. Hear these stories at WeConsiderWA.org.
Oh, drat, I was driving along minding my own business when that vulgar leech hit my Beamer with his pickup truck. I fear I've fractured my clavicle.
I say, old boy, don't simply put it in the hands of your insurance company to sort it out. Talk with the dedicated rogue solicitors at the Advocates Law Firm.
Pipe down, you old sod. The Advocates will see your case through to the bitter end and won't sleep a fortnight until they have victory in their grasp.
Jolly good, old man. Jolly good indeed. You get injured, the Advocates get results. AdvocatesLaw.com.
What's up? It's your boy, the Ted Smith. Thanks for listening to the Men's Room Daily Podcast. Want more? Check out the greatest podcast in all the land, The Podcast. Be sure to subscribe and listen to a brand new episode every Tuesday night.
Part of it better to drink in town.
Somebody out there deserves to be recognized. And the Men's Room knows just who it is. Whoa. So to you, we say, bottoms up, sailor. You're the toast of our shot of the day.
Drink time it is, and as usual, we head to the drink desk and Steve Thrill Hill to find out who we're toasting.
Real quick, show of hands, how many people think that Sammy Hagar performs the song A Pain in the Grass?
You think so?
How could he not?
Well, I don't know.
We can ask him.
Because it's mostly instrumental. You know what I mean? Like, it's a fun song, but it's rocking. I just don't know.
Man needs a break.
Okay.
Well, it's Sammy Hagar. Yeah, it is The Circle. I mean, that's the same band.
I mean, this is his tune, man.
Technically, it's Michael Anthony on bass. Same people. They should know the damn song.
Actually, I want to meet Michael Anthony.
He wrote it.
Today, we toast Mr. Stephen Owens of Polk County, Florida. Now, sadly, Stephen's time on this earth has come and gone, but his legacy lives on, and it lives on the headstone at the Warren Power Cemetery. So under his name, if you're looking at his tombstone, under his name and obviously the dates of birth and death, it reads, quote, forever in our hearts, until we meet again, cherished memories known as our brother, father, papa, uncle, friend, and cousin. Very kind words. Now, all of those kind words are listed in seven lines, all right? So that when you read only the first letter of each line, Steve's real personality shines through. Because it spells, and the family assures us it's quite intentional, F off. So again.
Oh.
So
brutal.
So top line, forever in our hearts. Second line, until we meet again. Third line, cherished memories. Fourth line, known as our brother. Known as our brother. Next line. Father, papa, uncle. Next line. Friend and cousin. So basically, yeah, F off.
Mm. Ooh, I like it.
Oh, yeah. They were like, look, he was all of those things, but also, I guess that was kind of his catchphrase to anyone in the family. Grandkids, nephews, everyone knew him for that. So the cemetery's now mad. I think it's brilliant. Yeah. I need you to take a look at that, Ted.
Yeah, Mike just pulled it up. I'm like, oh, man.
I know. That's fantastic. I want to get S my D on that. Trust me. I've already started writing what I want. So we pour this booze, and we drink this booze because we think it's yummy.
Yummy!
So over the tongue and down the throat to party in our tummies.
Down the hola, bitchola.
The Men's Room presents Profile This.
And Stephen Thrillhill, could you please, everyone, how Profile This is played?
As sure as hell can, Miles. It's a simple game where we share with you a real-life news story, something that happened right here on planet Earth. And as you listen to the story, based on the stereotypes you believe to be true of people and the decisions that people make, we'll ask you what it is you think makes the story a story. Hello, Anthony. Welcome to the Men's Room.
Hola, bitches.
Hola. All right, Anthony, you understand how this here game is played.
Yes, I do. Now shut up and give me the charts.
All right. Spoken like a true addict. I appreciate that. All right, we go to Harrisburg, Pennsylvania, which, quick side note, I've been there. It's an asshole.
It is.
But this man...
Seriously, I do.
It's hell.
I want to be clear about this. When I say Harrisburg, Pennsylvania is an asshole, that's not even an insult. That is literally a description.
It's the capital, right?
The
president of the United States is from Scranton, which is north of there. He did describe Scranton as a hellhole.
Yeah, right. Hellhole.
He's from there. He was running. He said, Scranton's a hellhole.
Yeah.
The last time I went to Hershey Park, we drove through
Harrisburg. And I think I said out loud to my mom, this town just makes me sad.
It is. I mean, it is. It's that place.
It's a hellhole.
It really is. Unless you like soot, darkness, and people that are down under luck, then, hey, that's your Vegas.
You like $1.50 draft, though.
Hey.
The economy's just, it's horrible.
You know what else I like is that almost no one there gets carded. Because at the age of 7, you already look like you're 54.
There's a town beside there that's been on fire for the last 70 years.
He's not kidding.
They had to leave. Everybody had to leave.
They literally said, we can't put the fire out. And it's still on fire.
It's still on fire.
Like, you got to go.
It's a hellhole.
Harrisburg. But a Harrisburg man who was later caught masturbating on a bed at the hospital he was taken to, he told police that he fled from them because he was high. Now, after initially stopping for the Pennsylvania State Police in the Manchester Township, Arthur Mann of Harrisburg, he took off, rammed a cop car, then drove the wrong way on the highway. Police used a device to flatten one of the tires on his Acura, then used the maneuver to put him to stop to the chase. He faced a host of charges, including aggravated assault, fleeing or attempting to elude police, DUI, resisting arrest, and then he added the bonus of indecent exposure when he masturbated at the hospital. And it all happened because he was high. But what was he high on? Was he high on crack, meth, heroin, or PCP?
Sounds like a heroin could be the winner. What do you guys think?
Honestly, in that town, it could be anything.
And sadly, you're not even doing
it. Flogged a dolphin in the hospital.
I mean, it already been arrested.
Anthony, I'm going to go crack, man. You can still perform on crack. I've heard.
You know this from experience?
I had a buddy and he did a lot of that. Not a lot, but he was able to perform sexually. So I'm thinking, I trust that guy.
You trust your friend who is
he was able to get an erection on that drug.
Anthony, if you can't trust a crackhead, who can you trust?
That's right.
Right. So he was
sure enough.
I don't know the
he
other
was
drugs.
In a right. He was in the hospital, high speed chase.
Afterward.
Yeah, afterward. That's right. Yeah. So they took him there. He got a little injured in the chase, and they get in there. He's, you know, waxing puppet.
And I can't decide if he's on meth or PCP.
Okay.
I think I'm going to go with PCP.
So it was all driven up the about 81 there.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Actually, it was on 83.
Yes. 83. Anthony, PCP, heroin, meth, or crack? We need one.
Well, if your friend has that experience with the crack, I'm going to change it to crack instead.
Okay. We're going to find out what this guy was doing. Was it crack, meth, heroin, or PCP next?
That was a tease.
This podcast is brought to you by the Washington State Department of Health. As we continue to listen, learn, and grow, we are amplifying Black voices and perspectives in an effort to start a new COVID-19 vaccine conversation. We're sharing stories intended to help us navigate this unprecedented time together and to co-create solutions in support of the Black community. Hear these stories at WeConsiderWA.org.
99.9 KISW. We return to the men's room with Miles and Thrill.
Category strikes on profile. This guy, PA man, he was fleeing from police. Told him he was high. He was. They felt like he needed to be hospitalized, so they took him there. And apparently they didn't strap him dead down to the bed because he...
Not all of them.
Yeah. Either way, he was definitely on drugs. Was it crack, meth, heroin, or PCP?
Anthony, that is the very question we asked you. Let us start with the very own D. Ted Smith.
Oh,
you remember
the
old PCP?
PCP.
No. He didn't fight the cops. He masturbated.
Okay.
It's a thin line between fighting and masturbating.
It really is. If you interrupt me, we fight. If you don't, I masturbate. And Anthony, you agree with Miles Montgomery. You said crack. Miles bases this on a former, building mate?
Guy knew.
The guy, what, lived below you or above?
Yeah, below me, Bernie.
Is that the guy who stole your cat?
Yes, correct.
Okay, so the man who stole his cat.
He used to smoke a lot of crack.
He could also get erect while he was high on crack. That is Miles' background on this. You agreed?
Right.
Boom! Oh, you are correct.
Boom.
You know what, man?
Boom.
I feel like you should reach out to that dude and be like, boom. Look, a lot of people probably say a lot of bad things about you. You don't realize what it is that you've done for people.
So Bernie told you all that, huh?
Yes, he did.
While he was having sex with
him. He's a winner. Now for all TV news of all time for TV time with Ted.
And now, because your pathetic life is confined to countless hours in front of a talking box,
Armageddon.
The Men's Room presents TV time with Ted.
All right. Choices today, you got the Jimmys.
Come on, Fallon.
Writers.
Wow, Writers in already.
Seth Meyers. Mm-hmm. Or Ted Smith.
I thought the Writers were on the strike.
Or is it late?
No. And our late night show, we actually support the Writers.
It is right there in the title. These guys have teams of talented writers and help them come up with their monologues each and every night. It is up to you to determine, is this an actual late night joke and from whom, or could it be a V. Ted Smith original?
Dr. Fauci tested positive for COVID, but luckily he's only experiencing mild symptoms. COVID must feel like he just reached the final boss in a video game.
Myers.
Fallon. Fallon.
I read that Dr. Fauci has tested positive for COVID, but luckily he's only experiencing mild symptoms. Yeah. COVID must feel like it just reached the final boss in a video game.
Yeah, we did it.
A so-called food-conditioned bear ripped into his family's a family's tent to steal food, begging the question, am I a food-conditioned bear?
Me, Ted Smith.
How about you?
It's like, I feel you, bear.
Food-conditioned bear, any animal in the wild, their whole entire life is based on two things, eating and having sex.
Right.
That's the whole point. Sleeping, in their case, half the year.
And not dying.
Right.
I just feel like
when
I come home drunk on the weekends at 2 a.m., am I the food-conditioned bear?
I mean, if you smell popcorn, you go, where's the popcorn at?
You know what? You're right.
I
literally woke up this weekend and smelled bacon and got out of bed.
Yeah. Is that food-conditioned dad gets up to eat breakfast? He walked in the kitchen. He walks in the tent. He smells the food. Don't put the food in the tent.
Right. God, I do it every time like a Domino's guy passes me on his bicycle.
Right.
I purposely slow down and go...
Are you a food-conditioned pedestrian?
That's a supreme. That's a supreme. Ooh, right. Double pep.
Oh, pineapple.
Microsoft formally shut down Internet Explorer. Well, technically, it just shut itself down and they couldn't restart it.
Seth Meyers found.
That's Meyers.
Microsoft formally shut down Internet Explorer. Well, technically, it just shut down itself and then they couldn't restart it.
There's a salmonella outbreak, so the CDC has instructed people not to kiss or snuggle their chickens. Although, if you're kissing and snuggling your chickens, I'm not sure salmonella is your biggest issue.
Fallon. Oh, that's you.
That's Fallon.
Amid a salmonella outbreak, the CDC has instructed people not to kiss or snuggle their chickens. Although, if you're kissing and snuggling chickens, I'm not sure salmonella is your biggest issue. I think...
Looking at you, Taryn.
Yeah. Boy, if you're at the roast, goats.
Coors has recalled a ton of beer due to its cans being filled with slime.
Mm.
You'd think it'd still be drinkable, but it's not. It's snot.
It's snot.
Fallon.
It's snot.
Fallon.
Kim.
Riders!
Damn it!
Riders coming in strong today.
It's not.
They're the opposite of on strike. Yeah, I know. I screwed it up. Sorry, Ryder. So,
it's not. I mean, it's not.
A man in the UK recently got a tattoo on his feet to look like they're a pair of shoes. Said the man, it hurt, but not as much as the underwear.
Myers.
Yeah, so,
A man in the UK recently got a tattoo on his feet that looks like a pair of shoes. Said the man it hurt, but not as much as the underwear.
That would seem weird, but honestly, when I heard that joke, I was like, that'd be a cool tattoo.
People do some interesting things. One of my favorites, it's stupid. It's a bald dude, but he lets the hair toward the bottom of his neck kind of grow horizontally. And then what he did was just tattooed another face on the back of his head. So it looks like that face has a big-ass mustache.
Oh, nice.
It's not something I would do, but I thought it was hilarious. And all I could think is, I would hate to sit behind him on a plane. Like, I know he's not looking at me, but I feel like he's staring at me.
Some big news for the sports world today. Like, I don't think anybody's shocked if you follow soccer and you live in the Seattle area. Everybody knows the Seattle Sounders FC and their fans do a great job of packing that stadium.
Absolutely.
We saw it with the CONCACAF Champions League final. So the World Cup is coming to the United States, Canada, and Mexico in 2026. And Seattle will be one of the host cities.
Yay! So if you don't understand, like, there's a ton of cities, so there'll be, like, games here.
I don't think they've announced where they're going to have the final and everything else like that. I can't imagine it being Seattle.
Mexico City's on there, Toronto, there's international.
Right, like Mexico City's on there, like Kansas City's on there, they have good fan support. You have L.A. I always just feel like, and granted, I'm just going back to 94 when we hosted a World Cup.
Yeah.
But like, if it's going to be in the States, I feel like the Rose Bowl is just the spot you'd have it at. And it's also a massive stadium.
Mm-hmm. And the new L.A. stadium is spectacular. Quick side note, if you are a Sounders fan, just know my sister-in-law works for MLS. And she's like right below whatever the Gary, whatever the hell his name is, the commissioner.
Ridgeway. Garber.
Because she calls him Gary. All of us call him
Gary. Don Garber?
Whatever, Gary. She just says Gary. Gary all the time.
So weird.
Just Gary. Anyway, whatever the case, she goes, look, man, she does the books. Okay, so she does the books and all the auditing for all the teams. And she goes, look, make no mistake about this. The money, as far as fan support, now it's not just showing up at the stadium, but the merchandise you buy, man, all this stuff, it is the Sounders, it is the Whitecaps. Period.
Yeah.
No one else comes close. So just know, good on you, Seattle, man.
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, there's a lot of cities. Say Atlanta has a strong base. And this
they
and
do.
I'm just thinking about it. If you're having a World Cup final, you want to have it at a massive stadium. So to me, like that's the Rose Bowl in the United States. You obviously absolutely have
whatever it is, Mexico City.
Estadio Azteca, right? Mexico
yes
City.
Yes.
Right, which is a huge one that's hosted them before and this and that. Sorry, Canada, you're not hosting the final.
Yeah. Wow.
Look, I'm just shooting them straight.
Right. I mean, it's the truth.
Yeah.
You're not getting
hating on nice people.
I figure it'll be, I'm just guessing, it'll be L.A. or Mexico.
Well, Vancouver, they have more of a little, kind of a more, a smaller kind of, the newer stadiums are building. They don't play in a big place, right?
B.C. place is pretty big.
Is it?
Yeah, only
people. They don't have like a boutique kind of.
I can't remember. I think it's bigger because the BC Lions, I believe, play there
right
as well.
All right, all right.
So it's a dual stadium. But right, generally, I only see it for the Whitecaps.
Yeah, a few cities have built smaller stadiums for soccer. So you have Philly's team that plays in.
They play in that smaller one right there on the river.
San Jose
built a specific
DC,
one. DC United built LA a specific one. Right, LA. Right, because right, you have they might have two now. Right. Because you have one for the Galaxy and one for LAFC.
FFS.
So, yeah, I mean, look, I always go back and forth as a Sounders fan. Like, it's awesome when we can open up the stadium when you're playing, you know, the Timbers or something like that, right? And you sell it out or fill it up. It looks cool. It looked great opening it up for the CONCACAF Champions League. I don't think it looks the worst, but, yeah, I mean, it's just hard to get more than 40 or 50,000 people, which is a massive number into every. Like, if you had it open all the time, I think it would look much worse because it'd just be empty seats everywhere. Yeah, I go back and forth on that stuff. Like, it is cool. Like, other teams deserve to play in the stadium. But I'm like, man, it just looks bad if you don't have enough people there. It's like when we talk about the USFL.
Right. If it's like, not Birmingham playing, it looks like crap. In spite of the fact that the football's there quality, the games have been competitive. But Gazzo just said, man, I watched it on Sunday. And he goes, if there are seven people there, I go, they're doing a hub city. If you know, so USFL, the Spring Football League. And actually, it has been a very enjoyable league, honest to God. But all of the games are played in Birmingham, Alabama. Birmingham has a team. When they play, the stadium's about half full, but you hear the crowd. It makes a difference, right? The other teams.
Birmingham is not a big town.
Right. Birmingham's not a place you just travel. There's nothing against Birmingham. It's not Vegas. Yeah. It's not New Orleans. It's not New York. It's not even Seattle, right, where people just go to see it. So when they do the games of teams that are not a home team there, there's no one in the stands, in spite of the fact that the games themselves have been really good. And some of these cats are going to end up in the NFL, right?
It's just tough, too. Like Mike and I were talking today about baseball and stuff, right? So I grew up, obviously, right outside of D.C. But, like, the Nationals showed up the year I left the East Coast.
Mm-hmm.
So I've never seen them play in their home state. So I think for this USFLs, it's in the one hub city. Like, right? Like, if I'm in Pittsburgh, which that team sucks.
Boy, their
it's hard to, like, have a big fan base. It's like, we've never even seen them play.
You've never seen them play to get behind them, and it makes a difference, man. You know, you go to the home team sport, you watch them play, and it just changes.
Also, I see you're wearing your Dragons XFL jersey today.
That is correct, yeah.
Yeah, when I was down at the rugby match to the Seawolves on Sunday, I ran into Broccoli Guy. Broccoli Man.
Oh, yeah!
He was born at the Dragons game. He danced out with the broccoli.
Nice.
I, of course, had a few pints in me. I walked by. I was just like, Broccoli Guy, you're an effing legend.
It's the number one vegetable. Listen to the segment.
Yeah, right? I mean, this is a big day for you, broccoli.
You're number one, man.
Mike, I always forget. Is he broccoli guy, broccoli man, broccoli dude?
Guy.
Broccoli guy. You've seen him.
I guarantee you made his day.
He's like banana guy at the concerts.
Banana guy's always at the concert now. This is kind of nice. Sesame. Sesame Street. Father's Day is this Sunday, if you haven't forgotten. Go get a tie or buy some food. I always found food goes a little bit longer. Like, as a little kid, I'd get my dad ties because he worked at a place that had ties.
Right. That's what kids do.
But, like, the older I get, the more, like, I'll see my dad this weekend. Like, we're going to spend the money on some blue crabs.
My kids, nice. What I found, you know, Father's Day, you know, as a kid, you don't mean something because you got a dad, right? And then I had kids, I got old enough, and it blows my mind and it makes me so happy. As a father, genuinely, I do not care about Father's Day. It's just a day. I understand what it's supposed to be.
Yeah.
Right? But your kids get so excited to do something for you that it makes the day worthwhile. So the last couple of years, I just said, well, look, the only reason I'm a father is because you guys are here. What do you guys want to do? Family Fun Center, ladies and gentlemen. But I will tell you this. It ends up
you always say it's a great day.
It is the best day because they're so excited just to be with you. Mm-hmm. And to them, they feel that this is your version of Christmas. You know what I mean? And yeah. You're kind of like, oh, sure. But
I've had a slice of pie and a brewski down at the Family Fun Center.
Yeah, great time. The go-karts, the video games, but they're so happy. So I always tell my wife, I'm like, look, even though they call it Father's Day, this is about the kids.
I'm doing it tonight.
Right? And I'm... Right, she's coming down just because Father's Day is this weekend. That's it, right?
Father's Day is Sunday. Sesame Street is celebrating by unleashing a Friends parody. Did you? It's a fun song that reworks the show's theme, I'll Be There For You.
Right.
But it has subtle Friends references. They made a rendition of Smelly Cat, which was like TV's kind of famous song.
Huge.
A puppet wearing Joey's Thanksgiving turkey hat and a nod to Ross's pivot. So... That's kind of cool. Sesame Street.
Hey, I'm not going to lie to you.
Stuff going.
There's a lot of people that could give you a tribute, whether an individual or... put it this way. If someone approached us and said, hey, man, a couple of guys that do the puppeteering on Sesame Street, love your guys' show.
All right.
They're doing a tribute to the Men's Room. I don't know, in my mind, that it would be a cooler honor.
Yeah, the Muppets are pretty
iconic.
It sounds
stupid, but like that, to me, would be one of the coolest things that could possibly happen. Don't name a library after me. If Sesame Street said, hey, man, we're going to do a shout-out to the men's room, like, in.
I'd like a lake.
When I was a...
we got to have a lake.
Lake Ted.
Oh, Jesus.
Or would it be Ted Lake?
I was going to ask you.
I like Lake Ted.
I'd go Lake Ted.
Yeah. Or it could be the lake.
There you go.
I'm looking at it, right? I'm like, somebody knows a lake around here. See if we can rename it.
Tell you.
No, I think that, yeah, lakes are great. Unless you're trying to catch fish in them. I still desire to catch one. All right, let's see. What do you got going on?
Wait, you've never gone fishing in a lake?
I have. I'm just making a joke. Last spring, I went to Lake Desire. Everybody caught fish at me.
So you desire not to go there again?
Well, all I caught was a buzz.
That's good. And you went fishing.
Mike, 10th season premiere of Impractical Jokers, woo! 10 p.m. tonight on True TV. You have Game 6 of the NBA Finals. That's the Celtics hosting the Warriors.
You think the Warriors taking this game?
I have said almost the whole time that I think this goes 7. Now,
I think the Celtics win tonight.
It's the NBA Finals. There's no option. We've already talked about that.
I thought
it was going to go 7 the whole time until the last game. The fact that Golden State still won with Steph Curry having an off night for Steph Curry. Like, you got Game 6 Clay showing up tonight, and I'm telling you, Steph Curry's going to go off. So that's why I'm like, they might beat Boston on their home court.
They might. I think that Boston might win tonight. I'm going to say Boston wins tonight.
All right.
Home court. They just went down 3-2. They had the third quarter of that last game said, you guys own this game. And then the Warriors came out and said, we don't think so.
Whatever the combination is, if you are in Vegas and you bet, just bet for 7. Whatever game, it just seems like, for whatever reason, the last 5 or 6 years, it always goes the distance.
Actually, someone looked it up for us, not the case.
It doesn't.
Does that NBA Finals?
Yeah. It seems like it.
I know. Well, yeah. Like, generally, the finals aren't that good. Some of the conference have been good.
Okay.
So.
Thank you, Chef. We appreciate it. You're listening to The Men's Room.
This podcast is brought to you by the Washington State Department of Health. As we continue to listen, learn, and grow, we are amplifying Black voices and perspectives in an effort to start a new COVID-19 vaccine conversation. We're sharing stories intended to help us navigate this unprecedented time together and to co-create solutions in support of the Black community. Hear these stories at WeConsiderWA.org.
The Men's Room returns with Miles and Thrill. Now, let's see what's happening in the real world.
All right, here we go. For some reason, grocery store employees call the cops when they find blocks of cocaine in their fruit.
Yeah.
Meanwhile, a Seattle man goes to Loch Ness to see the monster and is somehow shocked when the point is moot. Florida man with genius as a name is back in jail again. Commercial bus driver eats some gummy bears before his head began to spin. And an Alabama thief tries to escape by kayak and fails. It is time for your headlines.
Now, it's time to hit the headlines. Here's Mike Hawk.
All right, top story, we go to the internet where a Seattleite reviewed Scotland's Loch Ness in the most Seattle fashion. They burned the lake by saying that it's the most boring and overhyped lake he'd ever seen, going on to say that there was nothing remotely interesting about it and that Nessie is a hoax.
No offense, and I truly mean no offense, but are you stupid? It's a lake in Scotland.
Right.
All right. And Scotland, what do you think of Scotland? It's not some exotic locale.
No.
Right? And it's a lake. And lakes are just lakes. So other than the Loch Ness Monster, what is your draw to go to a Scottish lake? Furthermore, if you thought that, like, the monster shows up because you're there, you're stupid.
Right.
And it's fine. I don't mind being dumb, but, like, before you post all this crap, like, so negative, like, dude, it's a lake.
You don't go hiking around Scotland here to look for Bigfoot.
That's what I'm saying. If you came here specifically thinking, in the end, you would just say, well, it's just like a forest anywhere. Like, yeah.
You know why?
Because it's a forest.
It's no more interesting than Mount Rushmore. Look, gang, it's just a thing.
Right. I don't know what the guy's... What did you think?
Mount Rushmore always comes up. It's like the most disappointing one.
But at least that's man-made, and you go, hey, well, and disappointment is just, it's not as big as you thought. Not that the carvings aren't great in the artwork, but, like, you went to a lake in Scotland.
Right.
What in the F did you think was going to happen?
I went to Scotland. We drove right by it, and I almost missed it.
Didn't you pee in it?
I did. Yeah, we stopped there.
There's a statue in a town in West Virginia of the Mothman.
The Mothman?
Right. Which is...
Right. That's their legendary...
It's a ghost town.
Okay.
If you go there and you look at the statue, and you don't see the Mothman, you can't really be disappointed.
Exactly. I was wondering, what was the hype that he heard... Right. Run a lake in Scotland.
No. And you don't listen, you ain't gotta go to know it's a hoax.
Right.
Is this new to you?
Oh, okay. What do you know? It's full of a bunch of gimmicky tourist trap, you know, corner shops that just sell merchandise.
How do we know they're from Seattle?
Yeah,
a Seattle writer, blogger.
Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah.
Can't wait to read more of that.
Nobody hypes Loch Ness.
I'm not sure also that he wasn't doing this in a very tongue-in-cheek way.
Man, I hope so.
Based on how he wrote it, I was reading it. I was like, okay, maybe his frustration is obviously obvious to some degree.
But I'm
still not sure.
Saying that there's more beautiful spots to see in Scotland. Look, no doubt, I loved when I went to Scotland. Loch Ness was one thing that I forget to talk about. But again, it's not a huge doggone draw. Another news, we go to the Czech Republic where a banana shipment got a little more expensive. Employees of a grocery chain were unloading crates of bananas on the shelves that had been shipped from Colombia. As you might have guessed, while they were unloading the fruits, they noticed well-pressed packages of cocaine in amongst the bananas.
Why did you call the cops?
All in all, they found roughly $83 million worth of the drug in the crates. And authorities
found 92.
And authorities are working with international enforcement to find the source of the shipment.
Look, if you're a cop listening to this show, I got no beef telling you. If I buy bananas and there's cocaine in it, you will not hear about it.
You ain't getting it. That's it for your headlines. With that, Mike Hawk.
Sir, we appreciate it. It's your happy hour. It's up next exclusively on the Odyssey app. We'll see you for a little Dirty Big Dummy next.
Yeah. Yes, indeed. It's all true. In the meantime, well, we be all about this bitch for 180 seconds or so. So until then, please do what you do best. And for Aletha's sake, stay beautiful.
The Men's Room has been taped before a live studio audience. Wardrobe and makeup provided by Mantastic Limited. This has been a presentation of the Men's Room Radio Network.
Oh, man!
A Double Flush production.
This podcast is brought to you by the Washington State Department of Health. As we continue to listen, learn, and grow, we are amplifying Black voices and perspectives in an effort to start a new COVID-19 vaccine conversation. We're sharing stories intended to help us navigate this unprecedented time together and to co-create solutions in support of the Black community. Hear these stories at WeConsiderWA.org.
Realtors abide by a code of ethics. This is Article 9 in action. Beth, a first-time homebuyer, knew nothing about the home buying process, except that she wanted to buy a home. But her realtor had the expertise to make sure Beth understood every document, even giving her copies to review with her lawyer so Beth could close on her first home with confidence. Complicated things explained in simple terms. The difference between an agent and a realtor is real. Realtors are members of the National Association of Realtors. That's who we are.
20 million dollars, 19 million dollars, 6 million dollars. These are all awards recovered for clients of Phillips Law Firm. To win big, you have to fight big. And Phillips Law has been fighting the too big to fail insurance industry for decades. Not every case will have a multi-million dollar outcome, but Phillips Law will fight just as hard to recover the outcome you deserve. If you or a loved one has been injured in a car accident or on the job, call or click today at 1-800-JUSTICE or visit justiceforyou.com.
Visit Lowe's and take on the Pro Brand Challenge with the new Flex Stacked Lithium Battery. More power, longer battery life, and faster charging. Plus, it's compatible with all Flex 24-volt power tools. Right now, the more Flex 24-volt tools you buy, the more you'll save. Get up to $150 off today. Stop by or visit us online and see Flex. Exclusively at Lowe's. Valid 519 through 76. Savings vary based on purchase amount. Exclusive versus National Home Centers for Flex 24-volt. U.S. only.
Take the next step toward the career you want, be it business, cybersecurity, healthcare, or more. UMGC can help you get there. No application fee when you apply by August 31st. Visit umgc.edu, certified to operate by CHEV.